Hi, my name is Luca. I paint these paintings. They're based on a rework of the Baroque kind of theme, with all this black and the mystery. And it's also, there's lots of humor and grotesque, kind of taking the piece a bit. I also painted it a very nice and trying to paint nice. In a classic way, very academic. Thinking of Caravaggio and people of that era. And that's it. I hope you like it. I love being part of the exhibition. I think it was a great experience. We had a massive turnout of people. We had so many people around, and our curator, Shitsko, she's the most amazing person. She loved everyone, everyone loved her, and we are very happy.
Hi, my name is Daphne Bamagnotti. This is my work. It's called Wire Happy Women Series. As you can see, it's five figures. The main idea was based on a statue found in Austria. The name of the statue is Venus of Willendorf, and I think it was, it's 25,000 years old, so it's this small figure in the size of a hand that people used to use to pray. And so that gave me the idea of starting drawing, and this is actually the 3D, a 3D approach to my drawing. This is actually the first important exhibition I've ever done in my life. Lots of people were interested in my work. That made me so happy. Lots of people actually bought my work. That made me even more happy. And I think this is the whole show that Sitsigo put up is the most fantastic thing I've ever seen in my life so far. And I look forward to having the next one in the Spazio Gallery. Yeah, I'm making new one, which is bigger than this one. And, well, it's early work, it's early to say so far.
I'm Humphreys, I'm a sculptor. I've been working in film and television for many years, making figurative images. One of the things I first made many years ago was Max Hedley. And from that, I developed my fine art sculpture to distort images to create and hint at a fourth dimension. The idea of my work is to create a spatial problem rather than answer a spatial problem. So when the viewer looks at my sculptures, they're trying to figure out what they're exactly looking at, whether it's what dimension they're in. So it's like a voyage of exploration on it. Over the years, I've started to do portrait sculptures of people in this style, which has become popular in recent years. This has been a brilliant exhibition for me because my work has been placed in the window, so there's so many people wandering around the street, coming in, seeing the work, who've never seen my work before. Sometimes I show the Royal Academy and big exhibitions like that, but it's around here you've got a whole new audience who've never seen my work, so I'm really pleased about it. At the moment I'm finishing commissioned works of art from certain clients I've got, and then after that I've got exhibitions in May for the Society of Portrait Sculptors, and then at Gloucester Cathedral.
Hello, my name is Hidegato Sobabe, and I'm making the my artwork, which is like painting, drawing, and sounds, and sculpture. My work is always relating between the sounds and painting. And I'm very happy about the joining to this biennale. It's a really wonderful show. Probably I'm gonna make another sound things. Also, some more. I'm working with a paper at the moment, so let's try to combine it together. And making the new series of the artwork.
My name is Stefan, and I'm doing the pop art you can see on there. I do mostly in paintings, but I try sometimes the 3D. Before doing the art, I was doing in advertising. I was an art director at the big agency. And at that time, I was a young art director. We have to do all walls layouts the same way some my art is known. I was very proud to be him. And I think it's a different styles, and the people are so kind. So I was very, very happy every time I went at home. And I got some exhibition here in this year. I will go in the autumn to Berlin, to the Art Week in Berlin, where I've got an invitation to exhibit. But otherwise, I'm just with a new one in the 3D. But it will take about 1 year more than it will be finished.
Hi, my name is Silvio Severino, I'm Brazilian. In my work, I've been very much influenced by surrealism and Dadaism, and principally pop culture. In this work, I recreate video covers. As a young man, I was always interested in music, and the vinyls was fascinating me, the shape and the pictures I see in the vinyls, and I connect them in a different ways. Oh, for me was a wonderful opportunity. I really love to be here. My next project will be the recreation of the Last Supper from Leonardo da Vinci with vinyl covers. I changed the Sands and the Jesus and the Judas with vinyl-related musicians.
My name is Anna Cocherio. This part, this chair, is called my ideal blue chair. It's part of a series I've been exploring related to the image, and I call the imaginary, the real, and the symbolic have been quite explored in Lacanian psychoanalysis and the reader's ideas and etc.
So I'm a medical artist, and I work a lot with wax and 3D material, to create artworks which are anatomically inspired, and but still they have a story to tell. This one, for example, the hands, is a sculpture which I made for an exhibition called The History of Hurt. It portrays some praying hands, but at the back of it, the hands have been cut off. The hands are also mummified, which shows that kind of holding on to old dogmas and religion, but actually the loss of hope. This one is also called The History of Hurt, number one. It's a heart which has several wounds in it, and inside you can see the heartstrings beating. It's lying on a newspaper full of news, which is world news, which is very sad and emotionally provocative, and absolutely delighted to be in this wonderful gallery in the Truman Brewery. Well, I'm curating an exhibition in honor of Andreas Vesalius, which is a 500-year-old anatomist, and it's his 500th anniversary this year.
I'm Brian Green. I started off as a figurative sculptor, and slowly got interested in poetry, and in a way, my idea now is that poetry has become a kind of slower art form, and sculpture has to be very quick. And for me, I like to make very quick sculptures and longer poems, which is kind of not the way it's supposed to be, maybe. Well, the starting point for this work really was questioning what an artist's role is in this new century that's coming, where I find science to be, in a way, the major force that's shooting ahead. And so in questioning and trying to understand the things like quantum physics and string theories and entanglement, I came up with this work, which is really based on the fact that as an artist we're entangled so much with the past that we have to maybe free ourselves of a certain amount of our knowledge in order to be able to move forward into the new world. And so this work is about entanglement with the past, maybe using an image that many people know Van Gogh, and also his walking stick and his pack of paintings, that painting that Francis Bacon copied and or worked from. And so this is like an extension of that work, and this would be perhaps looking at what would be an artist's tools of the trade, and in fact not really knowing what to take. So setting off on the road with a kind of weird collection of stuff, including batteries for energy and weird wires and some earth and some string, and in a way totally uncertain of what the tools of the trade are.
Lulu Hancock, fine artist, lecturer, painter, illustrator, corporate artist, corporate work behind the wall. So I'm particularly interested in a sense of space, sense of place, sense of being, and trying to recreate that with contemporary thought process. Contemporary architecture is one of my real big passions. But I'm an expressionist painter, which is quite weird when you're looking at the work that's here. But when you break down the expressionist painting in simplistic form, take it down into layers, overlay it, this is what I was trying to achieve. I work in thick paint normally, and I work with I try and work in a three-dimensional sense. I'm a frustrated sculptor. So the experimentation with the works that are behind me is like childhood memory, travels abroad, bringing in that sense of Japanese architecture. I was in residency in Japan for 6 months, 6 weeks, and the colours and the work was just overwhelming. And I've got an exhibition coming up in France at the end of this month, and many aspects of work online at the moment, and I'm working with contemporary architects making work for space. So that's the corporate side of it, the expressionist side of it. I want to exhibit as often as I can in as many different places as I can. And the chance to be here in Truman Brewery is just wonderful. And it's been a great show, and everyone's been fantastic.
My name is Imogen Eveson, and I've been exhibiting as part of the No Barking Art Biennale 2014. I've got three photographs in the show, and they're very small, as you can see. But I played with the presenting of them. I tried to make them more like objects to compensate for their size. So the fact that they're now more like objects pleases me. And I think it makes it quite interesting, and people stop and want to investigate what they are. I took all of these photos on my old Olympus camera, so they're all on 35mm film, and there's not really much photoshopping going on apart from, you know, a few tweaks. This one's double exposure. I'm hoping to have that in the next exhibition in April, but to make it a lot bigger so it will have a lot more impact. This is the first time I've ever shown any photography or any work in an exhibition, and it's been a really nice experience to be part of it. I'm going to move to Sydney and hopefully take everything that I've been doing in the past few years with me, and I'm applying for a position of an editor of an online cultural guide, which would pull together all of my interests. So I've always been about writing and imagery, and I'm always trying to find a way to actually contain all of those things, and I think editing might be one of the ways. And that lends itself to the fact that I'm also going to be working on the book for the No Barking Artists, so that all links in together well.
My name is Ava Antinen, and I'm originally from Helsinki, Finland, but currently located in London studying and doing art. I work mainly with video and photographs and object installations. Mostly my work is concentrated on finding uncanniness in mundane and different states of being and being present.
Hi, I'm Tony Smith. I'm an artist and garden designer. I design gardens, particularly for the Chelsea Flower Show, as well as installations and pictures. The pictures I'm exhibiting here are made from sand and lacquer. They're inspired by the landscape of Iceland, and a long-held fascination with sand and small particles, particularly reading a book about quantum physics last Christmas, which I got two-thirds of the way through before I got lost. But the fascination with how massive things are made with tiny particles, and for me, sand is a tangible way of dealing with that. So making a landscape on the wall out of millions of grains of sand that represents or gives a feeling of something massive, but is in fact constructed of intricate particles, is for some reason very fascinating. It's great to be involved with this exhibition, particularly because of the diversity of the work and the fact that there's so much interesting and varied work that you can't help but be fascinated by it.
Hello, my name is Chris May, and it's been a pleasure to show at the No Barking exhibition. Everyone here has been very kind and helpful and very lovely, really. I've brought along a selection of paintings, wanted these paintings on the floor, which I never had before, my paintings on a floor, which is very interesting indeed. So a slightly more conceptual idea. Generally quite traditional, have things on a wall in various spaces, but this is a whole new thing for me, and I'm just getting used to the idea now. These are quite small, dark, intimate paintings, and what I could really hope for is that people will go into the paintings more than the paintings jumping out and being, you know, full of colour and excitement. They're much quieter, subtle paintings, and that's what I'm really trying to achieve with that. It's like a small, intimate conversation than something a lot more grand and loud.
Hi, so I'm Eloise Green, and this is my piece. I haven't really called it a title yet, but it's like the main idea of it was like, because the straitjacket is such a terrifying thing actually. I wanted to show how it can also be beautiful, because the people who wear it are like really fragile actually, because they're stuck in their thoughts like completely, and I just wanted to represent that because it's kind of personal as well, because like I'm kind of stuck in my thoughts, and the only way I can show that really is to show like something that's really punchy and like scary, that it can be beautiful as well. And I'm so happy I could be in this exhibition really, because I'm quite young actually. I'm 18, and this is my first exhibition I was in, and especially this location is great because it was like Brick Lane. I've always loved Brick Lane. The atmosphere and stuff is so inspiring. Like, I've always been inspired by the people. I'm also very inspired by my sister, because like we know each other's ideas. So this, like, some of the pictures are from my sister, and some of them are from my friend. And she knows, I mean, I tell her everything, so she knows actually what I want in the picture. So it really helped to create the whole atmosphere, you know.
My name is Ebru Varol, and I came to the exhibition from New York. I used to live in London. It's good to be back to London. I am really glad to be part of this exhibition. And our curator did a great job exhibiting these pieces next to each other. And it worked out very well. This piece is called New York is a Misty Moment. And it was, the fog was settling, and it was like that maybe 20 minutes or something. And I love New York, so I'm originally from Istanbul, and I love London, I love New York, I love big cities. And New York is everything I wanted. So this was, for me, it was very lucky moment. We were having a meeting, and I needed to cut the meeting to, you know, take time out with my beloved New York, and it worked out very well for me. And New York can be mysterious. New York can be anything you wanted, and that moment it was very mysterious, very it's there but it's not there. With its crowd, it can be lonely, it's very crowded, but you know, it was just right. So, and these little pieces Shizzy wanted to show with this piece. These are the objects that we walk by without thinking. They are there. We are in a hurry. We don't see little things around us. And I love capturing them. When I applied for this open call, I applied in the meantime Art Basel and Galleria Zero interested in my work, and they would like to show some of my work in June in Basel, and then later on maybe in New York.
I'm Sinclair Watkins. I'm American. I'm here at the University of East London getting my master's with Shizi and showing this work. A lot of it is about tattooing and body adornments. Even the drawings are abstract dudes, fashion portraits, sort of how we decide to portray ourselves and how we identify ourselves by using these physical things to show what's inside. And I'm going to be part of part two in April at the Espacio Gallery. Past that, there's talks of another gallery showing, but I'm not quite sure. I graduate in September, and then I'm going to do quite a bit of traveling and probably move back to America and go from there. So,
yeah. Hi, I'm Jamie. I'm an artist, and I specialize in recycle art and giving rebirth to the dead things I find. So, I'm going to talk about my work. This piece is called Gunshot King, and most of the pieces that I found are found locally in the woods. So, most of my things have a personal meaning. I've actually touched every piece of the art here. We've got another show coming up, part two in April. I'm really excited. We're going to have four new pieces showing. And I'm just so grateful to be here. I've had such an amazing time. I feel so lucky to be here. And I just can't wait for the next show and to show my new work.
Are they ready yet, or are you still
Yeah, working? I've got four pieces ready, and they're just waiting to be put into the next exhibition.
My name is Lucy S.M. Johnston. I work figuratively in all kinds of mediums. These behind me here are kittens rendered in pastel. That's not true. Chalk, in fact, in chalks, and I do paint photography as well, and you know, all manner of things to do with mark making. It has actually been amazing. It's been really great to be with so many professional people, especially for people who have come abroad, and it's not just kind of like a London community, it's much wider. So yeah, it's been a really good experience to be included. But all the kittens are kind of about subversion of the cultural meme in terms of, you know, kind of like kittens on the internet and swearing. Quite a fan of both, although I could take and leave both. But I do have a kitten from this. I manifested a kitten, and the person that I answered the advert for showed me a kitten that was exactly like that one, and charged me exactly the same money for one of them I'd already sold. So, really good. I like things to be circular sometimes.
Hello, I'm Tess Williams, and I have been part of the No Barking exhibition here at Truman Brewery. I'm a large-scale abstract painter. I'm currently doing my master's at Central St Martin's, and it's been great to be part of this show. I've showed here at the Truman Brewery a few times in different exhibitions, so it feels very comfortable but still exciting to be showing back here with a great bunch of artists and with Shizuko, who's been a great curator and a great help to all the artists, so it's been a really good experience. Yes, I'm going to be at the one at two at Espacio Gallery, so that's good to look forward to, but yeah.
Can I
Draw you in.